turi mu kwezi kwa 10 na kabiri.
We are in the month of December.
Nu kwezi kurangiriza amezi yandi.
It is the last month that closes the year.
Dusigaranye ibyumweru nka bitatu.
We only have 3 weeks left.
Imbere yacu kugira ngo mwakurangire.
Before the year comes to an end.
Twagenze urugendo rurero kuva mu kwa mbere.
We have traveled a long journey since January.
Kugeza ubu mu kwezi kwa 12 ariko kwezi kw'ingororano yo gutona.
Until this month, which is the month of affection.
Gutoneshwa n'Imana, gutoneshwa n'inshuti, gutoneshwa n'abavandimwe.
To have affection from God, to have affection from friends and from brethren.
Ndibuganire namwe ijambo rivuga ngo umutoni.
I will discuss the theme affectionate person.
Watoneshejwe umutoni.
The one who has been who has received affection.
Turareba mu itangiriro kuko niho dukura iri jambo. Itangiriro 35, 16 na 20.
Genesis 35:16-20.
Bava I Beteli baragenda bari bashigaje akarere bakagera muri Efurata. Rachel araramukwa aragumirwa. Kandi akigumiwe umubyaza aramubwira ati witinya kuko uri bubyara undi muhungu. Kandi mwifarye ubugingo bwe buri mwigenda yita umwana Benoni ariko samwita Beniyamini. Rachel arapfa bamuhamba mu nzira ijya muri Efurata niho Betlehemu. Yakobo ashinga inkingi ku gituro cye ariyo nkingi y'igituro cya Rachel ikiriho na bugingo n'ubu. Amen.
Then they journeyed from Bethel, and when there was but a little distance to go to Ephrath, Rachel labored in childbirth, and she had hard labor. Now it came to pass, when she was in hard labor, that the midwife said to her, "Do not fear, you will have this son also." And so it was, as her soul was departing, for she died, that she called his name Ben-Oni, but his father called him Benjamin. So Rachel died and was buried on the way to Ephrath, that is Bethlehem, and Jacob set a pillar on her grave, which is the pillar of Rachel's grave to this day.
Inguru ya Rachel na Yakobo ni inguru itangaje cyane.
The story of Rachel and Jacob is very amazing.
Akenshi hari rimwe tujya I Hebroni turi muri tour ya prophetic tour cyangwa se mu rugendo rwa gihanuzi.
Sometimes we go to Hebron when we are on the prophetic tour.
Iyo tugeze I Hebroni ni ku musozi hejuru.
When we get to Hebron, it's on a high mountain.
Kera bahitaga Kiriyat Araba cyangwa Aruba.
They used to call it Kiriyat Araba or Aruba.
Igihe cya Abraham yitwaga Mamure.
In the time of Abraham, it was called Mamure.
Muzabisanga ngo yari yicaye munsi y'igiti cy'Mamure.
You will read he was sitting under a tree of Mamure.
Imamure niho Hebroni.
Mamre is the same place as Hebron.
I Hebron kera rero kera cyane igihe cy'aba Abraham.
Hebron in a long time ago in the time of Abraham.
Yasanze banyirigihugu.
He went there and found the natives of that place.
Bukeye Sarah rapfa.
And then Sarah died.
Sarah fuye.
When Sarah died,
abwira banyirigihugu ngo mwantiza hano mpamba umupfu wanje.
He told the natives, "Can you give me a place where I can bury my loss?"
Barabantu beza cyane.
And they were good people.
Bamushira bamuha ubuvumo.
And they gave him a cave.
Aho ahamba umupfuwe.
They gave him a cave where he could bury his loss.
Arangije arababwira ati se nabugura.
And he said, "Can I buy it?"
Baranga batoya. Guhamba umupfu nta kibazo.
They refused and said, "Just go ahead and bury your dead person."
Abraham yari afite vision ndende cyane.
But Abraham had a very long vision.
Arabwira toya.
And he told them, "No.
Muhangurire.
I must buy it.
Sinshaka ubusa.
I don't want it for free."
Ariko wa mugabo ko duguhe ibyubusa ku kiwanze.
But they asked him, "We are giving this for free. Why are you refusing it?"
Aravuga toya.
He said, "No.
Mwe muhangurire.
Just sell it to me."
Batoke duha amafaranga.
And they say, "Okay, give us the money."
Bumvikana amafaranga rero agura ubwo buvumo.
They agreed on the price, and he bought that cave, and it was a big place.
Amaze kugura ubwo buvumo.
Once he bought that cave.
Ni aho niho haje kuba mu byukuri iwabo n'ubuvumo bwa bahambamwe abantu babo.
That's when they started to bury their people.
Rero iyo tugeze I Hebroni.
So when we get to Hebron,
twinjira hitwa Makpela.
We go into a place called Machpelah.
Aho muri Machpelah n'ubuvumo bunini cyane.
And Machpelah is a big cave.
Barwubatseho inzu ndende.
They have built a house on top of it.
Uhasangamo amasanduku atatu.
And you find three caskets.
Isanduku ya Sarah.
The casket of Sarah.
Isanduku ya Rebecca.
The casket of Rebecca.
N'isanduku ya Leah.
And the casket of Leah.
Ariko Rachel sihari.
But Rachel is not there.
Rachel ntabwo yagiriwe amahirwe yo guhambwa I Machpelah.
Rachel was not blessed to be buried in Machpelah.
We yahambiwe Efurata.
She was buried in Ephrath.
Dero Isa Yakobo avuye I Harani.
So when Jacob came from Haran,
ahobi bakunze kwita Padan Aram.
What they called Padan Haram.
Padan Aram. Aram ni Syria. Padan Aram ni Mesopotamia ni donc ni ichoge yari Syria yari Mesopotamia.
Haran is Syria. Paran is like Mesopotamia. So at that time it was Mesopotamia.
Uyu Musa ho hano ni muri Turkiya.
Today that place is Turkey.
Ni ku mupaka wa Iraq na Turkiya.
It is on the border of Iraq and Turkey.
Icyo gihe rero arataha subiye iwabo Yakobo.
So at that time Jacob went back to his home.
Harahantu yigeze kurara ahunze.
There was a place that he slept when he was fleeing.
Hitwa Giluze.
That place was called Luz.
Aharaye agirirwa ubuntu abona ijuru.
When he slept that, on that place, he saw heaven.
Abona urwego ruva ku isi rugera mu ijuru.
He saw a ladder going from the earth to heaven.
Abona abamarayika baruzamukaho n'abandi barumanukaho.
And he saw angels going up and down.
Ku mutwe w'urwo rwego abona Imana.
And on the top of that ladder, he saw God.
Akangutse aravuga ngo naraye mu irembo ry'ijuru.
When he woke up, he said, I slept in the gate of heaven.
Ngo nukuri inzu y'Imana.
Truly, this is the house of God.
Ahindura izina.
And he changed the name.
Yari wenyine.
He was by himself.
Asigaye yanditse ku ibuye ngo iyi ni Beth El, ni inzu y'Imana.
And he wrote on a rock, this is Beth El, the house of God.
Ariko hitwa Giluz.
But that place was called Luz.
Kuva uwo munsi yarahinduka bahita Bethel.
From that time, it was changed into a name Bethel.
Nanone iyo tugiye Shilo.
So when we go to Shilo,
tuci Bethel.
We go through Bethel.
Aho ni mu nzira mu misozi yo kwa Ephraim.
That is on the way in the mountains of Ephraim.
Aho I Bethel rero.
So that place Bethel.
Nyuma y'imyaka 30.
After 30 years,
turabona Yakobo aje.
We see Jacob coming.
Atari wenyine.
Not by himself.
Ari kumwe n'abagore.
He is with the wives.
Babiri.
Two wives.
N'ishoreke zabo ebyiri.
And four maid servants.
N'abana babo 11.
And 11 children.
N'abandi bakozi babaragirira.
And other shepherds who are tending to their
agarutse ari umutunzi.
He's coming back as a wealthy man.
Yagiye ari wenyine afite inkoni.
He went by himself with his staff.
Agarutse I Betheli ari ubusho.
He's coming back to Bethel as a congregation.
Icyamuzanye I Betheli.
What brought him to Bethel?
Kwari ugusohoza umuhigo yari yarahize.
Was to fulfill the vow that he had made.
Ngo kuva uyu munsi.
He said, from this day,
sinzareka gutangira Imana icyacu.
I will always give my tithe to God.
Icyongeyeho.
Another thing.
Zubakira Imana inzu.
I will build the house of God.
Ikindi.
Another thing.
Zongera namba z'Imana ya Abraham.
I will call upon the God of Abraham.
Yambonekeye ngenda.
Who manifested himself to me when I left.
None ngarutse amahoro.
And now I'm coming back in peace.
Abwira abana be bose ngo inzira from kuva I Padan Aram ni Bethel.
He told all the children, we are going from Padan Aram to Bethel.
Agezi Betheli rero.
When he got to Bethel,
akora iyo mihango.
He paid his vows.
Arahatura.
And he lived there.
Hanyuma igihe kiragira ngo.
And a time came.
Subira iwanyu kwivuko.
Where he was sent back to his native country.
Iwabo kwivuko hari Mamure. Ariyo Hebron.
His native country was Mamre, which is Hebron.
Muri urwo rugendo yari amanutsemo.
As he was going down on that path.
Yari kumwe n'umugore we Leah.
He was with his wife Leah.
Yari kumwe n'umugore we Rachel.
He was with his wife Rachel.
Yari kumwe n'abahungu babo 11.
And he was with the 11 sons.
Rachel yari yarabyaye uwitwa Joseph.
And Rachel had given birth to someone called Joseph.
Joseph yari umwana w'ikinege.
Joseph was a begotten son.
Ariko bari Betheli.
But when they were in Bethel,
Imana iza kwishura isengesho Rachel yari yasengeye muri Haran.
God answered the prayer that Rachel had given when she was in Haran.
Kuko izina Joseph.
Because the name Joseph,
birasobanura ngo Imana inyongere undi muhungu.
It means God gives me one more son.
Ibiziza gusohora ryasengesho bageze I Betheli.
And that promise was fulfilled when they got to Bethel.
Aratwite.
And she gave birth.
Icyo gihe ntibari bazi abana bari mu nda.
At that time they did not know the children were in the womb.
Nta ecography zariho.
They did not have echography.
Uretse umuhanuzi akubwiye ngo uzabyara umuhungu.
Except if a prophet told you you will give birth to a son.
Cyangwa ukizera isengesho wasenze ko Imana izarisubiza.
Or you believe that the prayer you gave God is going to answer.
Uko byagenze rero.
So this is what happened.
Baragenda.
They left.
Batekereza ko ashobora kuzabyara bageze I Hebron.
They were thinking that she will give birth when they get to Hebron.
Baramanuka.
They went down.
Bagera mu gihugu cy'Ubuyuda bari bavuye mu gihugu cyo kwa Yosefu ari cyo kwa Ephraim.
They got they passed the city of Judah and they were going into Joseph Ephraim.
Bacha mu gihugu cyo kwa Benjamin.
They went by the city of Benjamin.
Baramanuka bagera mu gihugu cy'Ubuyuda.
They got to the countryside of Judah.
Ni naho Hebron.
That is the place called Hebron.
Baraza bageze mu nzira.
When they got to close to the place.
Iruhande gwa Efrata hari intera ntoya ngo binjire muri Efrata.
Before they got into Efrat.
Efrata ariyo kwa Dawudi.
Ephrath, which is the place of birth of David, which is where Jesus was born in Bethlehem. At that time, it was not the Judah's countryside because Judah was not the son of Jacob. He was still a young son. He did not know that he would be given that countryside.
Abraham.
At that time, the whole country would belong to Abraham. As God had told him. So when they got to Ephrath, the woman went into labor. And she told the husband, I can no longer go. I am in pain.
Bahagari ku rugendo.
They stopped the journey.
Bicara munsi y'igiti.
And they sat under a tree.
Ibisebe mubana byinshi cyane.
And she went into hard labor.
Kugeza igihe byamugejeje ku rupfu.
To the point where it led her to die.
Muri kwa gusamba.
When she was agonizing.
Agiye gupfa.
As she was about to die.
Umubyaza ari iruhande rwe.
The maid servant was next to her.
Wa mubyaza. Aramubwira ngo humura.
The maid servant said, "Be at peace."
Ihangane wonge rusunike gato.
Continue to push.
Ndabona ubyaye umuhungu.
There is a son coming.
Muri uwo mwanya akukaga ko yari asigaranye.
In that short breath that she had left.
Aravuga ngo muzamwite Benoni.
She said, "Call her Benoni."
Uwo mwanya.
At that time.
Ahita arapfa.
She died.
Apfuye.
When she died.
Yakobo yihutira guhindura izina ry'umwana.
Jacob changed his name right away.
Mbere yuko ahamba umupfu.
Before she was buried.
Aravuga ngo ya mumwite Benyamin.
He said no, call him Benjamin.
Benoni birasobanura ngo n'umwana w'imibabaro yanjye.
Benoni means the son of my sorrow.
Benyamin, Ben Yamin, birasobanura ngo Ben n'umwana Yamin ukuboko kw'iburyo kwanjye.
Ben Yamin, Ben is the son, Yamin is my right hand.
Atoya, sumana y'ibabaro, n'umwana w'iburyo bwanjye.
No, he's not the son of sorrow, he's the son of my right hand.
Bamuhindura Josin uwo mwana.
And they changed his name right away.
Yitwa Benyamin.
And his name was Benjamin.
Mu Kinyarwanda bivuga neza Ben Yamin. Ni Benyamini uko muvyita Benyamini Benyamini
in Kinyarwanda
ucyongereza Benjamin ntabwo ari ryo zina ni Benyamini Benyamini
in Kinyarwanda it sounds good, it's Benyamini, but in English it's Benjamin. It doesn't sound as good.
Nyina yari yamwise Ben Oni.
The mother had called him Ben Oni.
Ben ni umwana w'umuhungu.
Ben is the son.
Ni mwene.
He's the son.
Oni ni imibabaro, mwene imibabaro.
Only is sorrow. And he said, no, you are the son of my right hand. The right hand in Hebrew, it means affection.
Ubutoni.
Affection.
Umwana utoneshejwe.
A child who has affection.
Sumwana w'imibabaro.
It is not a child of sorrow.
Sumwana w'agahinda.
It is not a child of grief.
Sumwana w'ibyago.
It is not a child of calamity.
Sumwana w'ingorane.
It is not a child of problems.
Oh, yeah.
No.
N'umwana w'ugukundwa.
It is a child to be loved.
N'umwana w'inkundwa kazi.
It is a child to be loved.
Uko niko Rachel bamuhamze Efrata.
That's how they buried Rachel in Ephrat.
Uzahabona aho banditse ngo imva ya Rachel muri Efrata.
You will see a place called the tomb of Rachel in Ephrat.
Iruhande rwaho haragasozi bamwitiriye kitwa ngo ni Ramat Rachel na gasozi ka Rachel.
Next to it there's a mountain. There is a mountain that was named after her. It's called Ramat Rachel. And that's where she died.
Undi arakomeza urugendo.
So he went on his journey.
Niho yageze I Hebron.
That's when he got to Hebron.
Aho niho yohereje Yosefu kujya gusura bene se I Dotani baramugurisha. Noneho umusaza afata Benyamin aravuga ngo niwe nsigaranye wenyine. Ntiyari yarigeze yemera mu buzima bwe kwatandukana nawe kuko yumvaga nawe azamucika nkuko Yosefu yamucitse.
It's when they settled there that Joseph was sold in Dothan and he decided to keep Benjamin so that he's not taken away like Joseph.
Aho Rachel yapfiriye ngo yashinze inkingi ku gituro cye ngo ariyo nkingi igituro cye iriho na bugingo n'ubu iyo ugeze Bethlehem iyi nkingi ya Rachel irahari.
And Jacob set a pillar on her grave, which is the pillar of Rachel's grave to this day. When you go to Bethlehem, you will see that.
Nagerageje rero kureba sintina muri histoire ye cyangwa se ibyabaye kuri we birasomwa muri Bibiliya ariko nereba umutoni iyo umuntu yiswe umutoni turi mu kwezi ko gutoneshwa ese umutoni akorerwa iki Bibiliya ivuga iki ku muntu utoneshejwe.
I'm not going to spend too much time on that story, but I want to emphasize what does the Bible says about the affectionate person. When someone is an affectionate person, what happens? If you receive affection, if you're in the month of affection, if this is your time of affection, what are the things you must be ready for? What are the things you must receive? What are the things that go before an affection? Try to see among these four things that at least you get one, so that we end the month with one of these special things.
Amen.
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 Ijambo rya mbere.
The first word.
Umutoni yicazwa ahantu hakwiriye aho ni mu kuboko kw'iburyo.
An affectionate person sits in a special place, which is the right hand, at the right hand. They sit in a special place. I want you to receive a place that is different from the places you used to have. If you are tired of the place you have been, if you are tired of the place you are working from, if you are tired of the place you are living in, if you are tired of that kind of life, there is another place you must go. That place is the right hand. God is going to take you from a place that you are used to a place you belong, at the right hand. The day Jesus overcame, the day Jesus won, the day Jesus rose again, he was lifted up before God. Before God, there was a place that had not been seated on anybody
but,
because that seat was at the right hand of the Father. He says, sit on my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool. When someone is seated at the right hand of the Father, you are seated in a special place of power. You are seated in a special place of glory. You are sitting in a special place of affection.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The
song of Solomon's writer.
He
says, may your hand be upon me and may your arm be around me. That is the affection of God. The right hand of God. May it cover me. May you hold me.
urukundo wabuze igihe kirekire.
The love you have missed for a long time. The joy you have missed for a long time. There is no other place to find it.
Ni mukuba ko kwiburyo
kwiye. It is in the right hand of God.
Ndagira ngo Imana yimuri cyicaro cyawe uyu mwana.
I pray that God will displace you in this time.
Imana yimuri cyicaro cyawe.
That God will change your position.
Ikwicaza iburyo bwawe.
That he will sit you next to his right hand.
Abanzi bawe baje munsi birenge.
That your enemies will go under your foot.
Hallelujah!
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 Hey!
Hey!
Urugendo rwatangiye mu buzima bwawe rukuganisha iburyo bw'Imana.
The journey to take you to the right hand of God has started in your life.
Icyicaro cyawe nigihinduke.
May your place of position be changed.
Kuba dashaka kugihinduka ni mugumaho. Ariko kuri twe bashaka kugihinduka nigihinduke.
For those who want to remain in that place, you may remain there, but for us who want to change, may it change. Because when someone is not in their right place, they do works that they don't want to do. When you are in the wrong place, you hear words that you don't want to hear. When you are seated in the wrong place, you live with people you should not be living with. When you are living in the wrong place,
utakaza confidence yawe, utakaza gaciro kawe.
You lose your confidence and your value.
Ariko urugendo rukuganisha mu mwanya uriho. Ko rutangiye uyu mwanya n'imitekerezo yawe itangire kuko hari yugiye, hari ibindi, hari abandi bantu, hari urundi rurimi, hari ubundi buzima kandi wifuje kuba mugiye.
As the journey is starting to take you to the right place, may your mindset also change, because where you are going, there are different people, there are different mindsets, there are different systems.
Psalm 80:17. Yeah. Ngukuboko kwawe kube ku muntu wo mukuboko kwawe kwiburyo. Ngumwana w'umuntu wikomereye.
Let your hand be upon the man of your right hand, upon the Son of Man, whom you made strong for yourself.
Mana, ukuboko kwawe.
God, your hand.
Kube ku muntu wicaye mu ruhande rw'ukuboko kwawe kw'iburyo.
May it be upon the man of your right hand.
Biratangaje.
It is amazing.
Byorohera Imana guha umugisha ku muntu wicaye iburyo bwawe.
It is easy for God to bless a person who is seated at the right hand of God. If you sit at the right hand, if you sit where God wants you, if you sit at the right hand, if you sit where God called you to be, it will be easy for his hand to touch your life. Say amen. The second thing that the affectionate person receives,
yambikwa umwambaro udasanzwe.
They wear a special garment.
Yambikwa umwambaro udasanzwe.
They wear a special garment.
Itangiriro 37 ku murongo wa gatatu.
Genesis 37:3.
Bibiliya iravuga ngo Israeli atonesha Yosef, Israeli ni Yakobo, ngo atonesha Yosef, ngo amukunda birusha ibyabana be bose, ngo kuko ari we yabyaye ashaje, ngo amudodeshereza ikanzu ndende.
Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children, because he was the son of his old age. Also he made him a tunic of many colors.
Iryo jambo ryo many,
many colors.
Aha, Bibiliya y'Ikinyarwanda yavuze ngo amudodeshereza ikanzu ndende.
The English Bible, the Kinyarwanda Bible said he made a long garment.
Kuko yakuye ubusobanuro bwayo muri tradition bita Septuagint.
He took the translation from the Septuagint version of the Vulgate version made by Jerome.
No muri Syriac.
Or the Syriac version.
Bo bayita ngo ni robe with the long sleeves.
Those versions use a robe with long sleeves, but this is a better translation. It says the robe has many colors.
Ifite amabara menshi.
Many colors.
Buri bara ryari ifite icyo risobanuye kuri Yakobo.
Every color had a meaning for Jacob.
buri bara ryari fite icyo risobanuye ku rukundo afitanye n'umwana we.
Every color had a meaning of the love that he had with his son.
Ngo mudodesheza ikanzu.
He made a robe for him.
Ngo yamubza yashaje.
He bore him in his old age.
Yego yabayeho imyaka myinshi.
Yes, he lived many years.
Ariko Yosefu yakoba yamubza yafite imyaka 91.
But Jacob gave birth to him when he was 91 years old. So when he had Benjamin, he was even older.
Amuha ikanzu ndende.
He gave him a tunic of many colors.
Ikanzu rifite amabara menshi.
A tunic of many colors.
Umwambaro niki?
What is a tunic?
Umwambaro ni izina ryiza reputation.
A tunic is a good reputation.
Umuntu utonesheje.
A person you receive
umuvuga neza kandi wifuza ko abandi bamuvuga neza.
You speak good things about him and you also want other people to speak good things
umusume,
about him.
Umusume Haman yaramaze igihe abwira Hasuerusu ububi bwa Mordekai.
There was a time when Haman was always talking to Ahasuerus about the evil deeds or the evil character of Mordecai.
Ndese bituma kubera Mordecai bafata ubwoko bwose bumwitirirwa bamwitirira we. Hari umuntu wanga umuntu mwene wanyu nawe yakubona muvuka na mwese akabashyira mu gatebo kamwe kandi byenda we ntacyo bikubwiye. Niko byari bimeze. Yabonye Mordecai amwitirira Abayuda bose. Aravuga ngo uyu tugomba kumanika tukamwicara n'Abayuda bose. Afete ni Mordecai yanze bituma yanga ubwoko bwe bwose. Hari abantu babi bameze gutyo. Ugirana ikibazo n'umuntu ugahita wangana bene wawe bose kandi ntacyo bagutwaye.
He took Mordecai, he hated him, and he combined him with all his people. There are such evil people who not only hate you, but they will hate all your people.
So
Ahasuerus was hearing those words for many days.
To the
point where he said, okay, what can we do? Let's kill them. He said, okay, I'll sign for you.
Ahasuerus ndiye arazi kumugorewe uba mu rubavurwe umutoniwe ari muri ubwo bwoko.
Ahasuerus did not know that the affectionate wife that she had was one of the people.
Mordecai bagiye kwica.
Mordecai they are about to kill.
Ntabwo yarazi ko ari we sebukwe.
He did not know that he was the father-in-law of, sorry.
Ni sebukwe w'umwami.
He was the father-in-law of the king.
N'umwami ntiyarabi yasinye ibintu atasomye.
The king did not know. He just signed things without looking.
Kuko Haman yari umutoni bwami.
Because Haman was an affectionate person. When you love someone, sometimes they give you things and you cite them without looking. Sometimes they even give you their signature to just sign everything and you leave. That's possible. He found out that he signed for the death of his wife and his father-in-law.
Kandi barinize kumubwira baribo.
And they had hid their identity from him.
Pe.
Truly.
Musubwe twigeze kuzana abantu Kigali.
One time we brought people in Kigali.
Barimo muri Afrika guruka barimo bigisha kubijyanye n'umusozi wa umusozi w'imyidagaduro n'umusozi we witanga no imyidagaduro.
They were teaching about, in Africa Arise, they were teaching about the mountain of entertainment. And in that time, people who were coming from here were teaching the youth. At that time, Elisha was in, yes, my son, he was in Kigali. And he went in that workshop. Because I used to go to different workshops to see how people are teaching. And I found him sitting in the back. And they were following. The teacher was an African-American woman from here in Houston.
No, mbaba mubazuko bimeze ko barimo bigisha.
I asked them how it was going as they were learning, as they were teaching. We talked. We asked a few questions, the people who are attending, to see if they follow. Sometimes I go to different workshops to see what the teachers are teaching the people. And people are introduce themselves.
And
the woman told me about her people because there were not too many, there were just a few of them. And then we left. And I asked Elisha how he went.
Arambwira.
And he told me, I asked him, why were you sitting in the back? What was the problem? And he said, I didn't want them to know that I'm your son. Is that why you sat way in the back? He said, sometimes it's uncomfortable. Because sometimes when you give your identity, even the teacher may lose focus. Even my name, I just say Elize. I didn't say my last name. And I followed him.
And I would
go to church and I would look for my sons and they would be sitting in the back and they told me that we don't want to be seated in the front chairs. We have our own places. I say, okay, as you wish. When I was thinking about it, a voice told me, this is wisdom. This is how Esther was. She lived with the king and she did not say the father. She did not say her mother. She did not divulge her brethren. Imagine loving someone and not saying anything, but they told you everything. As I make my story short,
Haman
rose up in the morning. He had a breakfast with Esther and the king.
Esther wo kwanga Mordecai ntiyarazi ko Mordecai ari cyo bapfana na Esther.
And when Haman was hating Mordecai, he did not know that Mordecai was related to Esther.
Yaraje gusangira na Esther ariko yashize igiti bikiraho Mordecai hariya mbere.
He had come to have breakfast with Esther, having left a post to kill Mordecai.
Nasobanukiye ikintu kimwe.
I understood one thing.
Abantu ni connected.
People
abantu barahuye.
People are connected. Sometimes people come and speak evil about your relative and you just keep quiet and you listen. That happens a lot. Not just that. There are some who speak evil about you because they don't know you. There is a... And they say there is a pervert and you start looking for the pervert, but they are talking about you. There is a difficult woman. Yet that woman is you. And you ask, who is it? Some people don't like to talk to sweeten stories. Others, they say, yeah, I know that person. I know where they live. And they are talking about you. That's how Haman came. He came to talk to the king. And the king asked him,
but they say, Haman.
A man, an affectionate person to the king, what can we do to that person?
Wagatima gaita kamukubita ati arundi atari njyewe.
So his heart told him, there's no one else but me.
But dore kina ko rutaravuga ibindi yambura uyu mwenda w'ubwamaka umwambika.
Before you go too far, you take off the royal robe and you give it to him.
Ati nibyo gusa.
That's it.
Batambo ibindi nabyo nibyiyongeraho yicara kuri iri ya farasha umwami yicaraho. Niyo yicara.
Additionally, you can have that person sit on the royal horse. But also that crown, that you can give that crown to him as well. Even that royal signet, you can give it to him. Also the scepter. And you look for a person who is great in the nation to follow him.
Ukamubwira ngo wege ndi nyuma y'umurizo w'ifarashi we umutembeza umugi wose uririmba uvuga ngo dore umwamakunda ngo umuto ni umwamuka bamukorera.
And you go around talking about the king, this person saying, this is the beloved of the king.
Umwamaramubwira ngo
the king saying,
ukora ibyo bintu byose,
do all those things,
ngo ntugire na kimwe wibagirwa,
and do not forget one of them,
ngo bikorere Mordekai,
and do that for Mordekai.
Hey,
do you know what happened? When people looked, because his house was the first, he saw Mordecai wearing the royal robe, and her husband was crying after him, saying, this is the beloved of the king. He went around the city. And the woman told him, his wife told the people around, it is over for my husband. Why?
Uko yari yanduje Mordekai yakuweho igisuzuguriro kubera umwambaro w'umwami.
The disgrace he had put on Mordecai was removed because of the royal robe that Mordecai was wearing.
Birashoboka ko izina ryawe ryandujwe.
It is possible that your name was disgraced. God will clothe you with his own garment. In this time, in these remaining weeks, may God clothe you with a good reputation. A good robe beyond what people think about. That will remove the thoughts that people had towards you. Clothe it in the name of Jesus. Take that cloth in the name of Jesus. He has many colors. The glory of God. The honor of God. May it be upon you. Clothe that garment. Wherever you go, may you be accepted. Wherever you get, may you be amazing. Wherever you go, may it work. This is what is done for the affectionate person to God. Receive the affection in the name of Jesus.
Number 3.
An affectionate person uses a special oil that is called the oil of joy. Say a special oil. A special oil. I know that when you are taking care of your body, there is an oil that is not compatible to a skin. There is lotion you put on. And that oil or that lotion causes your skin to be irritated. But there's another kind that matches your skin. When you know that, wherever it is, you look for it. So our bodies, they have compatible lotion or oil. An affectionate person, they have a special oil. That is the oil of joy.
Iyo watoneshejwe urishimye.
When you have received affection, you are joyful.
Iyo watoneshejwe ugira umunezero.
When you have received affection, you are happy.
Mu gitabo cy'Abaheburayo rimwe 9.
Hebrews 1:9.
Ngo kuko wakunze gukiranuka ukanga ubugome, nicyo cyatumye Imana ariyo mana yawe igusiga amavuta yo kwishima ikakurutisha abagenzi bawe.
You have loved righteousness and hated wickedness. Therefore, God, your God, has set you above your companions, anointing you with the oil of joy. The joy that the Bible is talking about. It is not a joy that you receive when you go to a store and buy things you like. It is not the joy you receive when they give you a raise, when you receive a raise at work. It is not a joy you receive when you have the child of the gender you desire. It is not the joy you receive when you find a partner to marry or to get married to. It is not the joy you receive when you receive things that you desire. That is a general joy. Anyone is going to get joyful when they
get joyful.
But this oil of joy, it goes further.
No mugihe abandi barira wewe ufite amahoro n'umunezero imbere abantu batakwambura.
Even when people are crying, you have joy and happiness and peace that people cannot take away from you.
Iyo wasizwe amavuta y'umunezero,
when you have been anointed with the oil of joy,
nubwo waca mu mwijima,
though you go through darkness,
nubwo waca mu mazi,
though you go through waters,
nubwo waca mu makuba,
though you go through calamity,
nubwo waca mu munezero,
though you go to joy,
nubwo wakomera,
though you go up,
nubwo wamanurwa,
though you go down,
nubwo wabyara,
though you give birth,
nubwo wapfusha,
though you lose,
furaha yetu itabakia ikiwa vyote vimetoweka. Umunezero ugumaho nubwo ibintu byose byagenda. Hallelujah.
That joy will remain even though everything else goes.
Uyu munezero ugira isoko.
That joy has a source.
Ku ntebe y'Uwiteka.
From the throne of the Lord. That's where it's flowing from. He pours this joy in your heart. Wherever you go with that joy.
Hallelujah.
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 Oh,
give Jesus glory. Give Jesus glory. When they throw the three young men, the Jewish men, into the fire, how can you sing while you are burning? It's impossible. You can only do it when you have joy from within. The wealthy people look for this and they cannot find it. That's why they divorce. If they had had it, they would have not divorced. The great sought it and they could not find it. That's why they don't sleep. The wise sought it and they could not find it. That's why they are always stressed out.
Uyu munezero nuzanwe nuko uzwi neza uvugwa neza. Uyu munezero uzanwa n'amavuta avuye ku ntebe y'Imana.
That joy is not brought by a good reputation or people talking good about you. It comes from the throne of God.
Umuntu wese Imana iponesha imusiga y'amavuta.
Everyone who receives affection from God is anointed with this oil.
Aya mavuta gumaho.
This all remains.
Uyu munezero gumaho.
This joy remains.
Kugeza hakurya y'uruzi.
Until the other side of the river.
Hallelujah!
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 Tuzatakaza umunezero wawe kuko ni ikimenyetso cy'amavuta wasizwe.
Do not lose your joy because it is a sign of the anointing you received.
Ukundwa n'Imana.
The one who, the affectionate person of God.
Rimwe mu buzima bwe.
One time in his life.
Ahabwa aya mavuta.
They received this oil.
Kandi uzabimenya ryari?
And when will you know this?
Nuca mu bibazo abantu bakagwirira imbabazi ariko wowe ukumva ari ibisanzwe.
It is when you go through problems.
Ibintu urabyihanganira gute? Ariko muri ukumva utahungabanye ni amavuta.
When you go through problems and people have pity about you and you tell them there is nothing wrong or you feel okay, that is the oil.
Bwana sifiwe sana.
Praise Jesus.
Mana mbere yuko imwakurangira sigira uyu muvandimwe wanje yamavuta.
God, before this year ends, anoint my brethren with this oil.
Furaha yetu ita bakia iki kwa vyote vinge toweka. Hale, haleluya, hale, haleluya, hale, haleluya, amina. Furaha yetu ita bakia iki kwa vyote vinge toweka. Hale, haleluya, hale, hale, haleluya, amen. Haleluya,
haleluya.
Oh, ichakane umutoni akorerwa.
Number four, what the affectionate person
receives,
which is the last one.
Ibiri iravuga ngo ngubukundiriza busukwa ku minwa ye.
It says, the Bible says, the lips are anointed with grace.
Ubukundiriza.
The lips.
Grace.
The grace.
Ubukundiriza.
What is grace?
Ubukundiriza ngo busigwa ku minwa ye.
Grace is is put on
the lips. Say grace.
Yes.
That's good. No wound.
It is grace.
Ariko rero ubukundiriza ni donke ni usigwa favere, usigwa mu buryo icyo uvuza abantu bakacyemera, icyo uvuza abantu bakacyishimira. N'ubukundiriza busizwe ku minwa yawe. Iyo ubwiye abantu ikintu baracyakira. Donc abantu biteguye kumva icyo babwiye cyose. Nguwo muntu ngubukundiriza busizwe ku minwa ye.
This is like favor. When you say something, people receive it. When you say something, people agree. This is of the favor of God.
Umwanya mbere yo kubonza narimo kurikira diskuru ya president wa Congo. Nafashe umwanya wo gukurikira diskuru ya muri gitondo.
At this morning before I came, I was following the speech of the president of Congo.
Arimo avuga ku byo yifuza gukora kuri Congo.
He was talking about his plans about the country of Congo.
Yakoresheje ijambo me compatriote inshuro nyinshi ni president. Me compatriote uvuga ngo abo dufatanyije cyangwa se bene wacu.
He used the words my fellow citizens, which is like my brethren.
Come, kum.
Fellow.
Kum, mukilatini ni ensemble. Kum, pachori. Kum. Donc, compatriote, kum.
Fellow or common.
Come.
Common.
Compassion.
That's where you get compassion.
Kum pachori. Yakoresheje ijambo kenshi. Compatriote, compatriote, compatriote.
He used the word fellow citizen, fellow citizen, fellow citizen.
Uzi icyo yashakaga?
Do you know what he was trying to do?
Kugira ngo abanyagihugu bamwumve. Yamanutse cyane ajya mu banyagihugu ngo banyagihugu bagenzi banjye banyagihugu.
So that people, the people may receive him, my friends, my people.
Iryo jambo yashakishaga iki? Ubukundirizo.
He was looking for favor.
Nicyo bita ubukundiriza. Niki jambo kubenza ngo Eric urabona ukuntu vraiment Eric wowe nubibona Eric n'ubukundiriza urimo ura insist uravuga iki kugira ngo abantu bemere ibyo urimo uvuga.
He was insisting and trying to convince and to have people receive the words you are saying.
Opinion ni nyinshi.
There are many opinions.
Bamwe hari abayikunze diskuru ye.
There are some who love that speech.
Then hari abandi batayikunze.
There are others who maybe didn't like the speech.
Biterwa n'abantu nabo bakonekse nabo.
It depends on who connected.
N'ibitekerezo.
The mindset.
Ariko ibyo yavugaga.
But what he said.
Birumvikana mu matwi.
It made sense.
Ariko byena ntibyumvikana mu nyungu zaba.
But maybe it did not make sense to the interest of some people.
Ushobora kuvuga ijambo ryiza bamwe bakarikunda abandi bikabarya kuko rikoze ku nyungu zabo.
You may say a good word, some will love it, some will hate it because it is attacking their interests.
Gusigwa rero ubukundiriza.
So to receive favor
ni ijambo usohora ari abafite inyungu arabatazifite bose bakumva ari jambo ry'igihe.
It is a word that you speak, whether people have interest in it or not, everyone receives it.
Umutoni,
an affectionate person, whatever they say, they receive. The king told Esther,
but Esther
he said, Esther, I'm tired. We have shared twice. When I tell you, tell me what you want, you refuse to tell me. And you ask me to share a meal again. Let us finish the issue here. Let me tell you what you're going to ask me. If it is half of the kingdom, I will give it to you. He wanted something that came out of the mouth of Esther because she had favor. When someone has favor on their lips, whatever they ask of God, they receive.
Impamvu amasengesho y'abantu atandukana niki. Wewe ushobora gusengera ikintu kibikemo ariko yagisengera bigacamo. Ndetse yanagusengera ibyo ukabibona. Wewe nyirabyo urabisengeye ndibikemo biterwa n'ubukundiriza afite gukanwa k'imbere y'ima.
The reason why people pray and it goes through, they receive the answer. They may even pray for you and your things may work out. It is because of the favor they have before God.
Hari umunsi umwimana yambwirije.
There was a time when God told me, go tell the Christians
ngo uyu munsi
that today
ibyifuzo byabo babiha abana babo batari wabisengera ngo kuko nibo numva,
that they should give their prayer request to their children and have them pray for them because they are the ones I listen to.
Iyo utarimo wigisha umwana wawe gusenga urimo wica ubukundiriza. Muri iriya myaka afite ubukundiriza ku minwa ye. Iyo umutoje gusenga icyo ahamagaye Imana irakimuka kuruta wowe icyo uvuze. Bawiriwe mu bintu byinshi bamwe tugira iminwa yanduye nka Yesaya ngo mana banzu yikishe wikara kugira ngo tubone kuvuga, ariko hari abandi bo Imana yasizeho ubuntu bwayo iyo bavuze Imana irumva. Witeguye kugira ubukundiriza ku kanwa kawe. Haleluya.
If you don't teach your children how to pray, you are losing because they have favor before God. Some people, they have bad evil lips like Isaiah. Are you ready to receive the favor of God?
Nizere ko hari favere y'Imana.
I believe there is a favor of God
igiye kuza ku minwa yawe.
That is about to come upon you.
Icyo usaba Imana izakiguhe muri
iki. Now whatever you ask, you receive in this time.
Amagambo yo mu kanwa kanjye nibyo umutima wanjye wibwira. Bishimwe mu maso yawe gitare cyanjye mucunguzi wanjye. Amagambo yo mu kanwa kanjye nibyo umutima wanjye wibwira. Bishimwe mu maso yawe gitare cyanjye mucunguzi wanjye. Nagiri umuntu ngo kuba mu bwiza bwe niho nduhukira. Reka manwa amagambo ava mu kanwa kawe ashimwe n'Imana muri ibi byumweru bisigaye ko turangiza uyu mwaka. Buri sengesho ryose uzakora, buri kintu cyose uzasaba Imana, Imana icyumve igusubize ivuye mu ndiba y'umutima wayo. Ikintu cyose kidaba mu kanwa kawe giheshe Imana icyubahiro.
May the words of your lips bring glory to God. May they be approved before God.
Zaburi ya 45 ku murongo wa 3.
Psalm 45:2.
Urutu bwiza abantu babantu ubukundiriza butsutse ku minwa yawe nicyo gitumye Imana iguha umugisha w'iteka. Haga umugisha w'ima.
You are the most excellent of men and your lips have been anointed with grace since God has blessed you forever.
Uratonye.
You are affectionate.
Uratonye.
You are affectionate.
Ubukunduriza busufi ku munwa wawe.
The favor is upon your lips.
Nicyo gituma Imana igiye kuguha umugisha.
That's why God is about to bless you. Receive the blessing in this moment. Receive the blessing in this moment. Listen as I conclude. The King of Kings is ready to give you affection. Be ready to follow him. The King of Kings is ready to give you affection. Are you ready to follow him?
Yihanganira ndangize kuri iyi story y'umukobwa w'umushulamu kazi cyangwa umushunemu kazi.
Allow me to finish with this story about the woman, the Shulamite woman or the Shulamite woman.
Ishulamu cyangwa ishunemi na kaji gatoya ikirorero gito cyane akadugudu gatoya.
Shulam or Shulem is a small town.
Kari mu majyaruguru ya Israel.
It is in the northern Israel.
Iyo uri mu kibaya cya Israel.
When you go in the valley of Jezreel, as you go up towards Galilee,
iburyo bwawe,
on your right hand,
hari umusozi,
there is a mountain,
aho musi yo musozi,
and under that mountain,
bawita umusozi More,
there is a mountain Moria,
umusozi More, More,
More,
More Mountain,
More Mountain,
aho niho Gideoni yagiye kurwanya aba Midiani, abantu banywa amazi hahanye. Yakuyemo abasirikare 300 ni kuri More. Iyo utaragira kuri More rero aho hari akadugudu bita Ishunemu.
More Mountain is where Gideon went to fight the Midianites, and before you get to that mountain More, there is a city called Shulem.
Aho niho Elisha yacaga igihe kinini umushunemu kazi yaramwubaka inzu.
That's where Elisha used to go by when the Shunemite woman built a house for him.
Igihe cha Salomo hari famiye y'Abanyafrika yari ituye.
In the time of Solomon, there was an African family that lived in that place.
Bahitaga Shulemu cyangwa se Shuna mu buryo Shulemu byende usana Shalomon Salomo ni jambo rijyanye n'amahoro.
Shulem, the name is Shulem or Shulam. It is goes together with Solomon or peace.
Uyu mukobwa rero Salomo yakomeje amuhamagara kenshi.
This woman was entreated by Solomon.
Nawe abona ibyiza byo kwa Salomo ariko akomeza ku rukundo rwe yarafitanye n'umushumba.
And he saw the good things about Solomon, but he continued to love his shepherd.
Kuko yari yarakunze umushumba we.
Because he had loved a shepherd.
Umva uko mu ndirimbo za Salomo rimwe kane bavuga ndimo narangiza.
As I conclude, this is Solomon 1:4.
Ahana umushunemi kazi aririmba abwira Salomo abwira umukunzi we ngo unkurure.
He was the Shunammite woman was telling his beloved, his lover, draw me away.
Nkurura.
Draw me away.
Niki yamusabiraga kumukurura.
Why was he asking him to draw him away?
Yarakeneye ko amukundwa kaza.
He wanted the favor.
Hanyuma abakobwa b'Isiraeli barasubiza ku murongo kurongo akurikira.
And on the following verse, the daughters of Jerusalem.
Ngo nugenda wenyine ngo natwe turiruka inyuma yawe natwe dukeneye affection.
They told him, we will run after you because we need that affection too.
Aba ni abakobwa b'Isiraeli basubije wa mushulemu kazi.
Those are the daughters of Jerusalem who responded to the Shunammite woman.
Hanyuma umushulami kazi asubiramo araririmba ngo.
The Shulamite responded singing.
Ngumwama maze kunkurura ngo yanjanye mu rugo rwe.
When the king drew me, he brought me into his chambers.
Yanjanye mu rugo rwe.
He brought me into his chambers.
Mu mwanya wa affection, ahantu urukundo n'ibyishimo.
In the place, the time of affection, of a place of love and joy.
Hanyuma baba kobwe mu Yerusalemu nabo bavuze ngo turagukurikira nabo bararirimba bamubwira ngo.
And the daughters of Jerusalem who say, we will follow you, the same singing.
Baravuga ngo tuzanezerwa tukwishimana. Ni wowe uzatuma twishima.
They say, we will be glad and rejoice in you. We will remember your love more.
Ngo tuzasingiza urukundo rwawe tururutishe vino.
We will remember your love more than wine.
Hanyuma umushulemi kazabwira wa muhungu yakundaga aravuga ngo aririmba ngo bafite impamvu rwose bagukundira.
The Shunammite told the young man she was singing to, rightly do they love you?
Ndagusaba muri ibi bihe.
I ask you in this time
ngo ukurugwe n'urukundo rw'Imana.
That you be drawn by the love of God.
Ibi bihe dusigaranye kurangiza umwaka.
This time that we have until the end of
we
the
year. Ukundi imana kuruta ibindi bihe ukurugwe n'urukundo rwayo ikwinjize mu byumba byayo aho uzabonera ibintu bitangaje.
Focus on God that you may be drawn by him, that you may enter his chambers where you will see amazing things.
Yesu yavuze kuri ibi byumba.
Jesus talked about these chambers.
Aravuga ngo ni ngerembo ni ngerwuri.
He said, I am the gate.
Ngo umuntu azinjira muri nge.
You will enter through me.
Ngo hanyuma sohoke.
And you will go out
and see
pastures.
The pastures.
They will see the pastures.
Tura experiment imana.
You have not experimented God. There is a pasture you have not seen. You have entered in Jesus. And then you sat in the living area.
Talking.
He will enter through me
masoke,
and he will go out
wasangurguri,
and he will find a pasture.
Yaho wichaye,
beyond where you are seated, there is a pasture.
Yaho uri,
beyond where you are, there is a pasture.
There
are many things that God has prepared for you beyond what you have seen. Beyond what your ears have heard. Beyond what your mind has conceived. In Jesus, there is much.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Ushim.
We praise Jesus.
Yes, Ushim.
We praise you, Jesus.
Muvandimwe.
Brethren.
Muvandimwe.
Brethren.
Imana nigusuke ubukundiriza ku minwa yawe.
May God pour his favor upon you. May he clothe you with a good garment. May he change your place. And may he change your life. Let us stand up and thank God.
Amagambo yo mukanwa kanje nibyumutima wanje wibwira Vishime mu Masi Gitare chanje Muchumbuzi wanje Amagambo yo Mukanwa kanje Nibyumutima wanje wibwira bishimwe mu maso hawe gitare chanje muchunguzi wanje muri uku kwezi ko gutonana
affection, Lord.
I ask you
that you sit your children at your
right hand
that they may receive a special place,
that
they may clothe a special
garment, that
they may be anointed with a special
oil, that they may receive a grace
and a favor
upon us.
From this day,
remember
them. Draw them
that they may walk in
affection, that they may rejoice
with you in
your chambers,
that they
may feel
your joy,
your love,
and
they may love you
back, and that they
may
love you back.
In the name of Jesus,
amen.
Amen.
Mutahane n'umwami Yesu.
Go with the Lord Jesus.
Yes, abagiriye neza.
And may Jesus bless you.
Tuzasubira ubutaha.